Hello everyone, once again in this video I will discuss some important thing regarding hydrogen bonding and some competitive question answers. Okay, hydrogen bonding is very much important topic because hydrogen bonding, the strength of hydrogen bonding depends on the electronegativity of the attached element. Okay, so the question very much common in chemical bonding, that is why H2O is liquid and H2S is gaseous, because this type of hydrogen bonding is formed in the H2O, and this type of hydrogen bonding can also form in case of what? In case of H2S. And hydrogen bonding, you know, it can be classified into two parts, namely intramolecular and intermolecular. Here the hydrogen bonding is intermolecular because one atom is attached with another atom, one atom is attached with another atom. But if you see the hydrogen bonding in case of ortho-nitrophenol, then the hydrogen bonding is intramolecular, because the familiar, within one family the different types of hydrogen bonding occurs. Okay, so as the number of hydrogen bonding, the strength of hydrogen bonding increases, that depends on what? That depends on the electronegativity. So here OH bond strength is much higher than SH bond strength, so the stability of H2 is much more than stability of H2S. That is why H2 is normal condition liquid and H2S at normal condition is gaseous. Okay, next question you can answer, that is between ortho-nitrophenol and between para-nitrophenol. Okay, this is your para-nitrophenol, ortho-nitrophenol and para-nitrophenol, which one will have, very important question, which one will have higher boiling point. Okay, so as in the para position, two groups, OH groups and NO2 groups are much larger as compared to each other, so this type of bonding cannot be formed. That is why in ortho-nitrophenol the bonding will take place like this. One ortho-nitrophenol can form the bonding with another ortho-nitrophenol, and these are intermolecular hydrogen bonding. So as intermolecular hydrogen bonding increases, so molecular chain length increases and thereby boiling point increases. So para-nitrophenol will have higher boiling point than ortho-nitrophenol. Okay, and which one is more soluble in H2O? Obviously para-nitrophenol. Why? Because in this sterically hindered position H2O, the attack by H2O cannot take place. Okay, but in this position this bond can easily be broken down. That is why para-nitrophenol is more water soluble than ortho-nitrophenol. Okay, last question. There are so many questions regarding your hydrogen bonding, but I will discuss all this type of question in my later video. Okay, this portion, that is, this is your what? This is your salicylic acid or ortho-hydroxybenzoic acid, and this is your para-hydroxybenzoic acid. Okay, so when they will liberate H+, they will form what? The COOO- and H+, because this hydrogen is more acidic than this. Okay, and this is the conjugate base. When an acid liberates one H+, this is formed the conjugate base. Okay, so here also it is formed. Clear? So we know that as the conjugate base becomes more stable, the acidity of the acid also increases. So this is the conjugate base of salicylic acid and this is the conjugate base of para-hydroxybenzoic acid. So which one is more stable? Of course this one is more stable, because it can form a hydrogen bond which is intramolecular in nature. But in case of para-hydroxybenzoic acid, this type of hydrogen bonding cannot take place, and therefore the stability of this is quite lower than this. So which one is more acidic? Question comes between this one, if it is 1, and if it is 2, which one is more acidic? Then of course compound 1 is more acidic than compound 2. Okay, so this type of more acid based related question I will discuss in my later video also. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe and like this video, and for further detail contact me. Thank you.